Worth mentioning from a cultural perspective, ancient Roman sexual mores were pretty interesting when it comes to attitudes toward homosexuality. In fact, the term itself, homosexuality, is somewhat anachronistic when ancient Rome and Greece, which was even gayer, are concerned, as the sex of the sexual partners was not important. Whether you were fucking a guy or a girl was not an issue at all. It was who was in the dominant position that mattered. There was absolutely no shame in fucking a slave boy so long as you were doing the fucking. If you were the fucky, the one being penetrated, you were putting yourself in the subservient position, and that was considered extremely worthy of shame. Giving head was even worse, since you were having your mouth fucked rather than your ass. Men's mouths in Rome were made for making speeches or ordering troops, not for being dick receptacles. In fact, the very worst sexual activity you could perform in ancient Rome was actually cunnilingus. Not only were you being subservient, but you were being subservient to a woman. Jupiter help you! Funny how this is now considered perfectly normal in the modern age, but male-on-male shit-stabbing is considered disgusting and degrading to so many. These days, an obsession with sexual domination is considered a kink. In ancient Rome, it was the norm. We know so much about these attitudes because they were outlined rather neatly by poets and writers at the time. For example, Martial's epigrams frequently contained verses about sex, masturbation, and all that good stuff. Since epigrams were often aimed at people, many of his verses deride his peers for their sexual preferences. There was an entire subsection of vocabulary based on such matters. Latin is an extremely precise and specific language for many things, but especially for obscene acts. Two of the most famous terms are in the very first line of Catullus's Commons 16, which is voted up to Reddit's front page pretty much every 6 months like clockwork, as people come across it and are genuinely amazed that Roman poets covered this kind of thing. Pericabo, I will buttfuck, and Iruambo, I will facefuck. Both of these are seen as hideously degrading, not because he's threatening to do it to a man, but because in both cases he's doing the penetrating. He's making the other guy his bitch. Although Catullus 16 gets all the press, it's actually Catullus being a bit of a wise ass. Most of his poetry is much more flowery and far less violent. He's putting it on, and it comes off as even more intense because his poetry is usually more florid and witty rather than so... in your face? Pun very much intended. Fuck you, I thought it was funny. But Horace wrote far more disgusting things on a far more regular basis, and although they often don't translate into English too well, some of it is wonderfully graphic. One of my favorite ever lines of Latin is from Horace's Epode 8, which roughly translates to, "And your anus hangs between your arid buttocks like a slaughtered cow." Back to sex. Let's take a look at some of Martial's epigrams, as they're a fantastic source for this kind of thing. First example, Martial's Epigram 228. My own shoddy translation is, "Sextilus, you laugh out loud at those who call you a sodomite, and you give them the middle finger, but you are neither a buttfucker nor a fucker of pussy, nor does the hot mouth of Vetustina please you. I say that you are none of these things, Sextilus, so what are you? I don't know, but you know which two things are left." The gag here is that Sextilus is denying that he likes getting penetrated, but since he isn't known to be the fucker, then he can only be the fucky. In this case, the two things Martial refers to are Sextilus taking it in the mouth and up the jacksie. Vetustina is just a girl's name, it's implied she's a whore. Or how about Epigram 256, addressed to Gallus, who was a common victim of Martial's awesome wit? My translation, once again rough, "Gallus, among the Libyan people, it is often heard that your wife is greedy, which is a horrible crime, but they're merely telling lies. She's not accustomed to taking anything. So what is she accustomed to? Giving it." Again, the implication here is that he's being fucked by his wife, shameful, rather than the other way around, player. One final example, this one is about as straightforward as you can get, Martial's Epigram 371. Quick translation, "The boy's cock is sore, Nevalus, and so's your butt. I'm no fortune teller, but I know what you're up to." This does not require explanation. It's 14 words of pure brilliance, and as great as it comes out in English, it actually loses rather a lot of its sting in translation. So there you have it. Gender isn't important. Whether it's a girl or a boy, wife or a slave, as long as you're doing the fucking, you're okay.